Welcome everyone. In the previous video, we had learned about components of blood. In this video, we will be learning about functions of blood. Blood is a red colored fluid present in our body. In adults, there is approximately 1.2 to 1.5 gallons of blood. Blood is approximately 10% of an adult's weight. Blood performs various functions. So in this video, we will be looking at few of them. So let's begin. Number 1. Transport of gases. We have already studied about respiratory system. When the process of respiration is on, oxygen is carried via blood from lungs to cells in various parts of body and carry carbon dioxide from tissues to lungs. So this is the first function, that is transport of gases. Number 2. Transport of nutrients. Simple nutrients like glucose, amino acids, fatty acids are taken up by blood from wall of alimentary canal and transported up to each cell in the body. Alimentary canal is the whole passage along which food passes. Number 3. Transport of waste materials. Nitrogenous waste like ammonia, urea, creatinine are released by tissues into blood, which carries those to kidney for excretion. So this is the third function of blood. The next function of blood is protection. Antibodies are produced in the blood and they protect the body from microbes and other harmful substances. Antibodies are proteins produced by body's immune system. It detects harmful substances and helps the body to maintain health properly. Then we have transport of enzymes and hormones. Enzymes are biological catalysts. Catalyst means it enables chemical reaction at faster rates. Blood transports the enzymes and hormones from the site of their production to the site of their action. Thermoregulation. Body temperature is maintained constant at 37 degrees Celsius by vasodilation and vasoconstriction. Vasodilation is widening of blood vessels, which increases the blood flow in a region, whereas vasoconstriction is the narrowing of blood vessels. When blood vessels constrict, blood flow is also slowed down. One more function of blood is maintaining the balance of minerals like sodium, potassium in the body, which is also very, very important. If bleeding occurs at an injury, platelets and a protein called fibrinogen of the blood form a clot and seal the injury. Clot means, as we know that blood is in liquid state, it transfers into a gel-like form, and hence it protects excessive bleeding. So this is also a function of blood. That's it for this video, students. We will continue with the remaining topic in the next video. Thank you.